I welcome you to this video tutorial, and in this video tutorial let's extend our concept of implementing basic gates in terms of universal gates, which we had discussed in our previous two videos, to implementing a simple Boolean expression in terms of universal gates. For this we have to follow a method called as bubble method. So, the aim of this video tutorial is to implement a simple given Boolean expression in terms of NAND gate using bubble method. So, here we are trying to implement a given Boolean expression in terms of NAND, that which belongs to universal gate category, using bubble method. So for this, let's consider a simple Boolean expression, that which is given by the Boolean expression y equal to a bar plus bc. Now our aim is to represent this Boolean expression in terms of NAND gate using bubble method. So this bubble method has its own steps, and the very step is, let's start with step number 1, that which says implement the given Boolean expression in terms of basic gates. So the very first step is implement given Boolean expression in terms of basic gates. That is by making use of AND, OR, and NOT gate. So now let's try to implement this given Boolean expression in terms of basic gates, that is by making use of AND, OR, and NOT. So as you can see, in our logical expression we are having A complement in turn OR with B ANDed with C. So in order to realize this, we require a single NOT gate in order to generate this bar, a single OR gate in order to generate this plus, and a single AND gate in order to generate this dot operation. So, logical diagram in terms of basic gates is given by considering A, B, C as our three inputs. So in order to generate A bar, I need a NOT gate. So this results me in A bar. Now I need to AND B with that of C. For that, I require a AND gate. So this output is B dot C. And in turn, I need to OR these two outputs. So in order to perform ORing operation, I require an OR gate. So this is our logical diagram in terms of basic gates. Now step 2, let's take up our step 2, and step 2 says apply bubble at the output for AND gate and at input for OR gate. So that is step 2 is we got to apply bubble at output for AND gate input for OR gate. And let me remind you, so right now we are trying to implement Boolean expression in terms of NAND. So basically, if you are trying to implement it using NAND, so then you got to apply bubble at output for AND gate and at input for OR gate. Remember this. So let's do that. So here, as you can see, here we are having a single AND gate. So according to step number 2, I got to apply bubble at output of AND gate. So this being the output of AND gate, I'll be writing a bubble here. In a similar way, I need to apply bubble at input for OR gate. So here we are having our OR gate, and here to its input I need to apply bubble. So these are step number 2. So after our step number 2, so let me rewrite this diagram again. So right now, after step number 2, we are having our logical diagram converted into this. And now let's take up our step number 3, that which says, apply NOT gate at places where bubbles have been inserted. So step number 3 is apply NOT gate at places where bubbles have been inserted. So as you can see, here we had inserted a bubble at the output of AND gate, and we had inserted 2 more bubbles at the input of OR gate. So I need to associate, or I need to insert a NOT gate in those positions. So for this bubble, I insert a NOT gate over here, and for this bubble, another NOT gate in the same path, and for this bubble, another NOT gate in this path. So this makes up our step number 3. So now I need to follow step number 4, that which says, look out for double inversions. And cancel redundant gates. Redundant in the sense extra gates. Redundant in the sense extra gates. So here, as you can see, here we are having 2 NOT gates in series, that which is of no use, that is extra. So thereby, I can cancel these 2. In a similar way, as you can see here, we are having 2 more NOT gates in series, and according to step number 4, I can cancel these 2. So right now, these NOT gates are redundant. Why? Because of our Boolean algebra law, that which says A double bar is equal to A. That is, this is called as double inversion law. So after cancelling these redundant gates, I'll end up with a logical diagram that which resembles this. So here we are left out with this kind of logical diagram, and right now I need to know what is this negative input OR gate equal to. What is this negative input OR gate equal to? And according to our De Morgan's law, we already know that if I consider this expression, so this is equal to A bar dot B bar. In a similar way, if I consider the other part of the De Morgan's law, that it says A dot B whole bar is equal to A bar plus B bar. So right now, because of De Morgan's law, we can say that negative input OR gate is similar to that of NAND gate. So here I can replace this negative input OR gate by a NAND gate. So continuing, so ultimately we have ended with our NAND implementation, wherein we are having just two NAND gates. So if I think of this to be my NAND gate 1 and this to be NAND gate 2, so here this output of first NAND gate will give me B dot C bar. In turn, the output of second NAND gate is A dot BC bar whole bar. And right now here, if I make use of De Morgan's law, so this is equal to, so if I break up this long bar, so the immediate operation below it, that which is multiplicative operation, gets converted to additive operation. And here I'll be having pieces of this long bar on the variables head. And again, according to double inversion law, I can cancel out these two. So this is equal to A bar plus BC. So this is how our bubble method works. Thanks for watching.